As you can see, I still prefer using Vago connectors for my electrical home wiring instead of wire nuts. Even though there were tons of people saying that my comparison tests were bad, pointless, or simply biased. And if you're completely confused right now, then make sure to watch my previous video in which I compared both of those connector types. But anyway, like I said, I will stick with my Vago connectors, even though they are a bit pricier. You know though, there are temptations out there on Amazon in the form of Vago knockoffs, which at first sight come with a better price point. So what can I say? I got weak and bought myself 7 different types of such Vago knockoffs. And in this video, I will satisfy my curiosity by not only finding out which one of those is the best and can potentially be a Vago replacement, but also whether there's truth to such a comment saying that Vago knockoffs can lead to fires. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by Keysight and their annual Test Gear giveaway and virtual engineering event, to which you can sign up now using the link below. This free 4-day event kicks off on May the 17th and features hands-on engineering tips and tricks, live Q&A with industry experts, and over $100,000 in prograde Test Gear giveaways. If you sign up for Keysight Live from the lab using my link, you'll also get a bonus entry into the giveaway, so go register now. First off, let me tell you that I found all my Vago knockoffs by simply searching for clamp lever terminal on Amazon and scrolling down a bit. And while their price points, forms, sizes, and number of clamping points all vary a bit, they almost all have one similarity. And that is the mechanical lever mechanism, which grabs an electrical conductor and pushes it onto a bus bar. And I said almost because I got one connector that, while featuring the same spring principle with a bus bar, instead of a lever comes with some kind of slider mechanism, for which you actually receive a tool along with the connectors. But anyway, I once again started my proper investigation by firstly testing out all connectors individually with a couple of different wires in order to come up with a suitable list of comparison criteria. Now this right here was my old test list for wire nuts and Vago connectors, but I think we can cross off the fast to use, reusability and flammable aspects. The reason is that even though all the levers, and of course the slider, all felt a bit different and thus required sometimes a bit more or less force to use, I always needed around the same time while using each, so I think they are all winners in this category. And they are also all reusable, because we are working with a spring mechanism here. And for the flammable aspect, I actually set them all on fire in order to find out that none of them alone would keep the fire going. But while removing 3 points from the list, I also want to add 2 new ones, called additional features and certificates, which I will talk about in detail later. So here's my final list, and each one of the 7 connectors in this race can win up to 3 points in one category, with 3 points meaning excellent, 2 points good, 1 point satisfactory, and 0 points meaning bad. So let's start off with ease of use, and for that I want you to imagine that I'm handing you all these different connectors, and you need to figure out how to use them, when you're allowed to use them, and with what kind of conductor. Now I think finding out how to use them is rather self-explanatory, and since they work with solid core wires as well as stranded wires, we do not have to worry about the conductor type either. But when it comes to the allowed cross-section, applied voltage and flowing current, then there are definitely differences between the connectors. And I'm very happy to say that really all connectors come with those information on them. Most of them even tell you how much insulation you have to remove from the wire. There were really only 2 which didn't come with the insulation information, and since exactly those also featured rather cheap and not well performing levers, I will have to deduct a point from them. But aside from those, the other connectors are easy to use and offer all information you could ever need, which means they all get 3 points. That brings us to the next criterion, extra features. And when talking about that, I'm not referring to the two connectors, which basically have two or even three separate terminals combined in one. And by the way, I measured the isolation resistance between those terminals with a voltage of 1000 volts. And it seems to be high enough to hopefully never cause any problems. No, I'm for one talking about such testing access points, and also the ability to secure the connectors in place with a screw. Needless to say, the testing access point is really handy to have when it comes to troubleshooting an electrical wiring or similar. And luckily, most of the connectors, except for one, came with such a testing point. And I also think it is kind of handy being able to screw connector in place with either extra holes designed into the housing itself, or having a separate adapter that adds such holes. So all test point connectors get an extra point, as well as all the screwable ones. Next we come to the size aspects. And here I have to say that all the connectors that emulate the size of the Vago 221 are, in my opinion, the excellent choice. The other ones are a bit thicker and thus look more like the old version of Vago connectors, which is good but not excellent. So 3 points and 2 points are the ratings I'm giving out here. That means it was next finally time for the very interesting price point comparison, which after doing a bit of research was actually a surprise for me. If we go by the price per piece ratio, then the VID connector is the clear winner here. But what is so surprising is that even genuine 2, 3 or 5 pole Vagos are cheaper than most of the knockoffs. Now you might be saying that is only the case because some connectors only come with a few units since they are featuring way more connection points. But if we calculate the price per connection point, then we can still see that VID and Vago are the true winners here. That is why the VID connectors get 3 points, while the other ones only get 1 point. So next, we come to the pull test, in which I simply placed a solid core conductor in the connectors, which I then pulled out, while measuring how much kilogram of force I needed to do that. For the most part, the results lay between 20 to 30 kilogram, which I'm only calling good here and not excellent, because there were two connectors against whose gripping power I had no chance, therefore deserving 3 points. But on the other hand, there was also one connector that didn't really grab well, and thus I could even remove wires with my bare hands, which I think is pretty bad. So after adding the new points, it was time for the super important resistance test, which is related to the comment we began with about starting a fire. You see, the higher the resistance, the bigger power losses get produced inside the connector, which eventually can lead to deformation, a loose wire, sparks, and ultimately a fire. And if that sounds too unrealistic for you, then definitely watch my video about different connector types and wire ferrules. But anyway, to measure the resistance of my connectors, I firstly created two pieces of solid core wire, of which I measured the voltage drop while 20 amps were flowing through them. By doing a bit of math, I calculated the copper resistance of them, which I can then subtract from the complete setup with the connector in place, so that we are only left with its resistance. So I hooked up the conductors to each connector, cranked up the currents, and measured the complete voltage drop at a current flow of 20 amps. And after once again doing a bit of math, we are left with this beautiful graph, which first off tells us that the blue slide connector features the lowest resistance. Excellent. And I'm happy to say that all the other connectors also performed very good, with a maximum resistance of up to 1.8 milliohm, which means time to give out lots of 2 points. Last but not least, we got the certificate aspects, which refers to the CE, UL, BDE and ENEC marking you see on the connectors. Those certificates basically guarantee that the product complies with certain standards, of which I think the UL one, ENEC one and the BDE one are the most important ones when it comes to electrical safety. And besides, of course, Vago, only the slide connector as well as the VID one comes with such certificates. The other ones all only come with a CE marking, which is satisfactory, but not excellent like the others. And with that being said, my tests are done. And if we calculate everything together, then we can see that the blue slide connectors as well as the VID ones are the big winners. Honestly speaking though, I feel like all connectors are suitable for hobbyist projects, and I can certainly not confirm that they will start a fire. And my personal favorite is the VID connector, which is not only cheaper than Vago, but also should be just as safe. So I might give them a try in the future, even when it comes to electrical house wiring. With that being said, I hope you enjoyed this video. If so, consider supporting me through Patreon. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!